Howdy folks, and welcome back once more. Let's play Dark Sun Wake of the Ravager and me attempting to move with WASD even though I know better and that it doesn't work. Today, a note. Get the note. The note details Kalaubuta's plans to ally with the Draxians in exchange for the return of the Templar's magic. It's just the sort of proof that Arslan is looking for. 20,000 XP, nice. That's substantial. Chunk dinged. One hit point shy from 100. One hit point, and then we have Rove, who, despite being 11th level, is still terrible. He tries real hard, though. And I mean, now we know Enlarge is just fucking busted, so that's gonna be making some things easier, I hope. I'm just gonna go ahead and save here. Freaking what? Minute into the recording, and the cowardice saves begin. It'd be funny if we had to knock to leave. Alright. Now where the hell? I think Arslan was up here? Yeah. What is this pathing? What is this pathing? Oh my god. So bad.
I heard there's quite a stink over at the Templar's offices. Wouldn't be your handiwork, would it?
I have the proof you wanted.
Another 10,000 XP. Oh, Goldleaf just dinged. Hell yeah, 10th level. I don't think that's another spell level for her. Arslan reads the note, horror quickly marring his features as he realizes that Tyr faces complete destruction if the Draxans carry out their plan.
You must get this information to the Veiled Alliance at once. I'll show you where the secret entrance to the headquarters is located. We've no time to waste. Are you ready to go?
Yeah, okay.
That's what I'd like to hear. Just follow me and I'll show you the secret entrance to the headquarters.
Please don't make me- oh no, I have to actually follow him. Oh, it's painful. It's so painful. The frames. The frames! He's gonna get away! See, this would be- oh hey, look, an ambush.
There they are, men! Kill them and the Lord Warrior will reward you well!
You're the one who will die, worm!
Brave talk for a dead man!
Why is Rove in the front row? No! Oh, looks like Chunk still has his enlarge going. Good God! No fucks given, just immediate death. Okay, Goldleaf. Yeah, you don't have... Normally it's 11th level for 6th level spells, but I don't know if clerics are weird in this, because I know they were in the older games. Let's see, manual, preserver, cleric. No, clerics get 6th level spells at 11th level, cool. What did she pick up? She picked up an extra first and third level spell per day, which I don't know. It looks like they did give them to her. Nice. Okay. Not really a lot we can do with that, admittedly. Kibbit suggested dispel magic for getting rid of battlefield control stuff, which is probably a good idea. Not something I'll likely use outside of combat, but in combat when things start flying around, yeah. And I mean negative plane protection's okay. And prayer is just kind of always nice to have, it's just a little buff and debuff to enemies, and I believe there's no save. But... what? The cleric spell selection in these games is so bad. Give us, like, magical stones or something, just some... basic bitch attack spell. Old person is situationally really good. Okay, Rove, buddy. I think you're probably out of anything that works. I'm gonna do something risky here. We're moving Rove in. Is it C to cast? Oh, it is. Good to know. I'm gonna try for the cone of cold. Oh, 60 damage. All right, I'll take that. 74. I'll take that too. All right. So who knows where Arslan got off to? Two-handed stone lotulus. More garbage. I assume these are probably just like all, yeah, just all kind of dregs. See, I have no idea where he got off to. Is that him? No. Is that him? No. Is this him? Yes. Okay, he's down in the giant skeleton room. Bro. And then he just left. Okay. So apparently the secret exit entrance. Oh, is it this fucking cupboard in here? It's gotta be. Okay, but I have no idea where he just fucked off to, so that's wonderful. Did he just go back home? He totally did. Oh my god, I hate this game. That is so bad. Oh, here, follow this NPC that moves super fast and erratically because the game's performance is shit. But also, they're gonna go back home, and also you can only see about 10 feet in front of you at any given time. Dude, I need you to show me again because the game's dumb. Ready to go? Yes. Okay, now we know where we're going, so I'm just gonna do this. And we'll see how bad our pathfinding is compared to his. Where am I going? This is not something that should be an issue in a game. Like, did he just go back home? He did. Grid-based pathfinding, like basic grid-based pathfinding algorithms, are something that if you're doing anything game dev related, like schooling wise, it's going to be one of probably the earliest things you are taught, because just using, oh my god, it's not a complicated thing. It is, but it isn't. Like, it can be very... No, you motherfucker. Oh my god. Yes. Oh my god, this jank fuckery. There's a staircase hidden behind the cabinet in the north room. Just push the button on the basin next to it, and the cabinet will open. Thanks for making that take 20 minutes more than it needed to, you fuck. You could have just told me that. Okay, there's a button in a basin. Ow. Oh, we had to approach them, okay. Fair enough. Everybody in the cabinet, we enter. Dragon Man angry.
Greetings! The Veiled Alliance welcomes you into our fold. I am Matthias Morton, the leader of the cells here in Tyr. Oslin sent word that you are checking on the Templars. Have you news of their doings?
Yes.
Matthias listens in grave silence as Swell explains the situation with the Templars and the forces of Ardraxa.
I have read about the city, but never once thought its people would venture from their valley in the Sea of Silt. Life preserve us. Tyr cannot hope to survive such a catastrophe. Already it is on the brink of anarchy. I knew we would face consequences for Kallak's death. But come, we must begin preparations for whatever they have in store for our beleaguered city.
Is there a place I can rest?
Of course, forgive my manners. I'm all too anxious to hear what you have learned in the Templar's offices. I guess the room awaits you. It's the first room to the west as you walk south down the main corridor.
So what are we going to do?
Right now, we must prepare for the worst. Study our enemy and gather our strength. Talk to Aleka. She will give you the names of some of the contacts in Tyr. My strongest advice, however, is to do some research of your own on the workings of these Templar.
And who is Aleka?
She's the one who handles communication between the Veiled Alliance cells and takes care of all of our day-to-day needs. Her office is just west of the entry hall.
How are we going to stop the Draxons?
Okay.
I'm not sure yet. Certainly the Draxons have been unable to complete any plans they have. To answer our problem will be found in one of the many books. Patience and wisdom, these are the virtues that will lead us to victory.
Okay.
How does Kallak's death figure into this?
Only in that when the sorcerer King Kallik was slain in his pyramid as he tried to transform into a dragon, a void was created in the power structure of Tyr. Kallik's evil was great, and I do not in the least mourn his demise, but it has had its price on the lawlessness in the streets, and now the attention of the dragon.
Where can I do this research?
We have an archive and research rooms in the northeast corner of the headquarters. You're more than welcome to use them.
I'll talk to you later. Goodbye.
I will be in my private room to the northeast. You are welcome to come talk to me anytime.
Alright. More XP. No levels, though. Mild disappointment. Alright, first order of business is finding our bed. Ooh. Well, they have a wizard, or an alchemist, it would seem. And more glowy tapestries that I have no trust in. Lootable chests. He said it was actually to the south, wasn't it? Not the north. Is it this room? Yes, it is. Oh, and they even gave us a storage chest. Wonderful. With a bunch of money in it that I don't care about. Why? Why do you... Oh my god. Why do you play sound effects when I have nappy time? Bunch of gems and shit that I've been, like, hoarding to absolutely no purpose. Maybe there's goodies hidden around. I don't know. Things worth buying. I'm kind of doubtful. I don't remember the shopping in the first game being too particularly useful either. Let's see, so we're just kind of looking around, scoping the place out for unattended chests. Metal chain armor, yoink. That's probably an upgrade for somebody. Metal chain. Yeah, bone brigandine. Pass it down. There we go, AC 0, hell yeah. Not bad. Really, like, Goldleaf probably isn't a horrible melee fighter. She's just squishier than I'd like. Can I open this? No. Oh, no. If this were the first game, I'd be able to open the curtain. But yeah, because she's got like what? She has 74 hit points. That's actually not too bad. Her strength is a bit lacking, but with strength of 1, we could bring her up to the other. Oh, we can just walk through the curtains. I don't know if that's better or worse. I'll take the loose ceramics, but I can't not take the big shiny gems. I just can't. Metal chain armor, hell yeah. No, open that. Take that. Because I think that might be an upgrade too. Oh, she's got metal chain. Bone brigandine, which is actually 4. I wonder if this was like magical or something in the last game, because that is just markedly better. Bone scale. Here, you can have some metal armor. It's more aesthetic. And this we can just drop. Who's coming into the Veiled Alliance, swapping all of the gear in our chests for worse pieces? As you step into the meeting room, you see an intense woman rallying her followers. The respect she invokes clearly shows in their faces. The time to act is now. We have hidden in the shadows long enough. Kallik has been dead for months, and what have we done for our freedom? Nothing!
Romelia's right. Fear is our only enemy now. The common people want the defilers driven from the land as much as we do. All we must do is teach them the truth about our magic.
But the people are not ready to accept magic in any form. Divulgence, if carried out, must be done slowly, like the gathering of dew, one drop at a time until the bowl is full.
Romelia turns and notices you in the doorway. She raises her hand and gestures to you.
Here are the new Alliance members, the kind we need more of. You've heard of how they fearlessly defied the Templars in their very stronghold. With a dozen just such as these, a half dozen, divulgence would be inevitable. The people would follow them in through anything.
What is divulgence?
Simply put, it is the idea that we in the Alliance should lift our veils and reveal to the public that we are wizards, that not all magic users are evil like the Defilers. This, we feel, can only strengthen us in our fight.
And what are we fighting for?
Look around you. Athas is a tortured world where even breathing can be painful when the hot winds blow.
We fight so a cool breeze will not be smothered with dust, so spring can nourish life before it dries up. It is the defilers who make Athas like this, and it is to them we take the fight.
That's a righteous cause. How can I help?
Man of action like yourself can help immeasurably. I think I know where these Draxons of yours are hiding. We'll hit them soon and hit them hard.
Okay, sounds like a good way. Well, why can't I ask you about this? What does Matthias say about all of this?
Matthias wants to keep the Alliance a secret, and we respect his leadership. However, Matthias knows it is a changing world we live in, and that the debate over divulgence can only provide us with more options.
Won't the people simply hunt you down?
They may. They see the blasted land around them and know it was magic that caused the destruction. What they don't know is that only magic can heal Athas of its wounds. That is what we live and die for.
So, for those who are not necessarily familiar with Dark Sun, she mentions that magic causes destruction. And that is basically what defilers do. So, mages, magic users, arcane casters in Dark Sun, they can cast spells. Or, they can cast spells and pull the life force from, like, plant life around them to either cast more spells or to cast them more powerfully. And defilers are mages that do that. And defiler mages are why the world of Dark Sun is a barren wasteland, because, you know, power, it does that.
Sounds like a good way to get killed.
You're right. To meet death in the name of life is the only death that I will accept. Come to my quarters later. They're straight down the corridor to the west. We can speak quietly there.
Okay. Romelia and the other members speak among themselves for a few moments before the meeting breaks up. Okay.
It's a distraction.
Got any loot in here? Oh, that looks like a lootable container right there. Oh, but it's not. I was betrayed. Is that? Oh, I do like the decor. I will say that they kept that up pretty well from the last game. All the little bits and bobs laying all over the place. I appreciate that. Oh, she's got a +2 longsword.
All right, Swell, we have us a deadly situation here with the Draxons, and I'm hoping I can count on you to fight as fiercely as you did for the Templar's offices. What we need is for someone to crush them, and quick.
Give me the word and I'll put an end to them.
With an attitude like that, those Draxons won't last long in our town.
What did you want me to do?
Like I said, we can't wait around for them to make their play. Take the fight straight to them and make them think twice about being in Tyr.
Do you know where they are?
The ziggurat.
Okay. I don't know where that is.
Why do you think they're in the pyramid?
It's the only place big enough and deserted enough to conceal them. And where else would the dragon want his sanctum? The Draxons aren't at the pyramid. We're in more trouble than I care to consider.
And how can I get into it?
The obvious entrances have long since been sealed off. Aleka can get you in touch with Tasarla. Names are hard. Our agent in the Shadow Square. She may be able to help you.
Do you have any advice?
Sure, watch your step. The Draxons are preparing a sanctum for the dragon. You can bet they're laying traps and wards to protect it.
Alright, goodbye.
Alright, so both her and the leader have told us to talk to this Aleka girl. So we'll be doing that. But first, I have to go through this place stealing everything that isn't nailed down and maybe of worth. I like all these little animated things. They make me so happy. The only other games that I can think of off the top of my head. Whoa, that frame rate. Look at that mouse cursor. Oh my god, it doesn't like it when I move it over the animated sprite. What is wrong with this game? Font, use it. Who will drink? Rove. Well, he ain't dead. He seems okay. Alright, video games. Anyways, among older games like this, the only games that I can think of off the top of my head that had environments with, like, all the bits and bobs like this, Albion was one, which is a game that I really should play on the channel at some point. I've had people ask me about it before. And then the Avernum games, they also have the crazy detailed environments. I know there are plenty more, because I mean, like Ultima, the Ultima games had crap laying all over the place, like especially starting with like 6 and 7.
But I don't know, when it comes to where my head goes, when it comes to really detailed environments in top-down games, Shattered Lands was always one of the biggins. Who are you? VA member. Thank you for your service. Who are you? Another VA member. All right. The party just comes into these people's rooms and rifles through their stuff and then leaves without saying a word to them. Chunk makes eye contact and they just freeze. Okay, so that's that branch of the place. I'm actually going to save again and turn the music back on because the silence is deafening. And all that wind, that underground wind that you're so familiar with. All right, there's the boss man. Metal chain. Which I think at this point we all have, yes. Fucking arena music. This makes me want to... Ooh, this makes me want to play Shattered Lands again. Hello, book. I'm gonna leave you alone. Ah, so good. So good. I can love the music in these games. Oh, that is... Is that a wizard's hat? That looks real weird. Yeah. Oh, bookcase. So it scans the book titles tucked in amidst them are a few magic scrolls. Oh, really? Oh, did I take them? Yes, I did. When you scroll of Spider Strand and a spellbook of Minor Globe of Invulnerability, that tentatively useful. Here you go, Rove. So what the hell is Spider Strand? Oh, there's a single strand of strong spider web to shoot forth from the caster's hand and entangle the target creature. To the manual! And this sounds like probably a low-level crap spell, but it might be something useful. I assume it's going to allow a saving throw, though, which actually isn't as damning in older editions of D&D than it is in newer ones, because this is a third-level or fourth-level spell, actually. Saving throw, it just says special. The target is immobilized until it can break free. One round a level. But yeah, scrolls and stuff are much more useful in like first and second edition D&D than they are in newer stuff because of the way saving throws work. Things have to make a saving throw, and the number they have to beat is the same regardless of whether or not it's from a scroll or a wand. Well, that's actually not true in older editions of D&D. Well, it kind of is. It's complicated. Saving throws were weird. Swell discovers the liquid in the alchemy device tastes worse than it smells. Like, I love to imagine Swell just goes up, sticks his fucking finger in it, pulls it out, and sticks it in his face. Okay, are you... You are not a Lekka.
Yes, did you want something? I'm Swell.
Yes, of course, the new members. I'm very pleased to meet you. My name is Namdi. Oh, that filter's starting to congeal. Excuse me. Hello, Swell. What can I do for you? I've only got a minute, though. Can't let this experiment spoil.
What are you doing?
Athas has me working on transformation magic. Since Kallak was killed in the very act of transforming into a dragon, we're very anxious to discover a way to counter it. Which reminds me, Matthias wanted me to give you this, the Scarab of Protection. Oh dear, if this gets too hot, it'll explode. Excuse me. Scarab of Protection, all right. It's a magic necklace. Be like, I would say, yeah, plus one AC. And protection from evil. That's Scarabs of... No, never mind. I thought Scarabs of Protection gave you magic missile protection, but I think that's like Scarabs of Missile Immunity or something. I'm going to give this the Gold Leaf. I hate that sound effect so much. So much. But yeah, anyways, I said saving throws were weird.
And the reason behind that is, scan the book titles, some have strange names that mean nothing to him, while others are written in unfamiliar letters. All the books, however, seem to be about Kallik and the history of Tyr. Alright. We need to find this woman that we're looking for, wherever she's hiding. Anyways, like, a spell might allow, like, for example, Fireball. If my recollection is correct, I think Fireball in older editions was like a save versus breath weapon to avoid it. But if you used it from, if you used it from like a scroll, it might be a save versus other thing, or it might still be breath weapon. But I know specifically if you cast a spell from a rod, a staff, or a wand, I think it was rod, staffs, and wands. There's a specific saving throw you roll against those, and they're typically a little easier than normal. Plus one tchotchka. All right, I'll take that. One plus one arrow is wholly meaningless to me, but this ranged weapon might be worth something. Let's see, D8 minus two, D6 plus three. Well, there you go, Swell. Upgrade. Wait a minute. I'll get two shots at the bow. So the average damage on the tchotchka is going to be, what is that, 3.5 plus 3, so 6.5. Whereas the bow is going to be D8, which is 4.5 minus 2, so 2.5, but twice, so 5. If I hit both times, so the average damage, even though I'm only getting one attack around, is better with the tchotchka. Okay. Goldleaf has her sling, which at a D4 plus 2 is actually pretty solid. So that's like 5 average damage, 4.5 average damage. And the bonus to hit is, of course, a winner. Yeah, saving throws in old D&D were weird, but I think I preferred how they worked over stuff like DCs and stuff scaling starting with 3rd edition, because it kept things like wands and scrolls and stuff useful past, you know, first level. Okay, where have I not been? She might be one of the VA members, actually, now that I think about it, because we didn't actually talk to them. Let's see, was it this one that had the woman in it? Yes, music. Hello. Hello, what can I do for you? I can't tell if you're a woman or an elf. I'm giving you a female voice. I'm Swell! Glad to meet you. My name is Sandira. Alright, you're not who I'm looking for. We're leaving. Goodbye. Just immediately walk away. Are you who we're looking for? Hello, is there something you wanted? I'm Swell! Glad to meet you. I'm Amal, one of Matthias' assistants. Bye! Okay, so the only other person that I haven't talked to is this person in here writing. And I was gonna say, yeah, there's the NPCs wandering around. We can pester them too. Are you who I'm looking for? Hello and welcome to the Veiled Alliance. My name is Aleka. No, we found them. I'm glad you came to see me. I've heard some disturbing rumors about you, or rather about some people looking for you.
Who's looking for me?
Oh, I don't know their names, but twice now one of my contacts has been questioned by a group of 6 men. Apparently they're offering a sizable reward for information on your whereabouts. Watch your step.
I can handle myself well enough.
Sure you can. You certainly handled yourself well with the Templars. Still, I think you should be careful. The Veiled Alliance needs as many people with your talents as it can get. Let's see. I'm leaning towards Romelia over Matthias. I don't know if there's like a right and a wrong way to do this, but Romelia has promised us violence instead of guile, and I'm not a subtle man. Romelia says I should talk to you about the pyramid. The pyramid? Isn't that a bit dangerous? Well, there are 2 people in Tyr that you should know. Arslan, who you've already met, and Tassala, who has run several missions against the Templars for us.
Tell me about Tassala.
Tassala poses a merchant in the Shadow Square, where she gathers a great deal of information for us. She will know you are with the Veiled Alliance if you ask to buy a jaguar cage.
And what do you do here, Aleka?
I suppose you could call me a facilitator of sorts. Mainly, I just make sure everyone in the different alliance cells are doing what they're supposed to.
And what am I supposed to be doing?
You're new here in Tier and Unknown. I think Matthias will want you to run infiltration missions like you did at the Templar offices.
And what do you know about the Draxons?
I don't know much. They've been rumors in the square about strangers in town, of course, but no one seems to know much. The information you got is the best we've had so far.
Time is leaving. Goodbye.
Bye, Swell. I hope to see you again soon. Okay. I have to say, I'm not a huge fan of the portraits for NPCs in this. I think they're probably... their art ripped from books and stuff, or maybe just hand-drawn illustrations. I don't think they fit with the game well. I much preferred the art for portraits in the first game. All right, Matthias.
Ah, Swell, come in and make yourself comfortable. Was there something I can do for you?
Let's see. What else do we have? Nope, just what is Divulgence?
What is Divulgence?
Veiled Alliance is a secret organization, not because defilers wield such great power, but because the very people we seek to help will strike out against any form of magic. The supporters of Divulgence think the secrecy should end.
Romelia says people are ripe for change.
Indeed, she has a point. You must remember, though, Tyr is in a unique situation with its Sorcerer King dead. People enjoy greater freedom than anywhere else, but that doesn't mean they are more open-minded.
Are you afraid the people will turn on you?
The people turned on magic users long before the Veiled Alliance was formed. No, that is not what I fear. What troubles me is that Divulgence may divert Tyr's energy away from establishing its own government, free from the tyranny of a Sorcerer King.
Isn't ignorance the cause of their fear?
That is an argument Romelia throws about, saying we should teach them the differences between good and harmful magic. But that would be a mistake. The people are better off keeping their fear.
Oh, rule through fear. Yeah, that's always the best course of action.
Won't Divulgence bring the Veil support?
Of course it will, but if defilers know where we are and what we're doing, a condition implicit in Divulgence, how long will there be something to support?
All right,
I won't disturb you anymore. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Yeah, definitely leaning towards the Divulgence side of thing as opposed to the rule through fear and, you know, just hope nobody gets corrupted at some point. All right, well, we were at 32 minutes, so I think I'm going to go ahead and save. And it looks like next time we're going to be going into a ziggurat and killing some Draxons, so that should be an adventure. Until then! Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. If you had a good time, check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, via the machine and all that. And as always, thanks for watching!